Hi everyone, my name is Sunil Kumar. I am studying final year engineering in Ballari Institute of Technology and Management in the Department of Mechanical Engineering. My seminar topic on Kai power generation under the guidance of Mr. Jay Prakash, Assistant Professor. The contents of a Kai power generation: introduction, Kai generation, need for energy kite, components, lifting mechanism, principle, working and comparison between the windmill and energy kites, advantages and disadvantages of kite power generation, and conclusion. Introduction. Initially, the kite power generation developed in Italy that takes power from the high altitude winds. This was originally conceived by Italian researcher Massimo. Kite generation organization was developed in Italy for adopting a green energy concept. The simple idea of a kite waving in the air leads to this technology. Kite generation initiated its first project called ladder mill that could generate 50 kilowatts of power. Kite generation. The first design of a kite generation is a small prototype. The electric actuator which holds the kite lines are fixed with respect to the ground. Need for kite energy kite. Why do we need energy kite kite power generation? Because it provides an 80% of electricity, environmental conservation, renewable energy resource, abundantly available, less area required for installation. Components in kite energy kite. Some of the components required for installation of a energy kite that are power rings, dynamic compass, steam, power joints, ground structure, rotating engine, power drum, control pulleys, and actuators. Lifting mechanism of a kite power generation has a two major groups, that is ground station and airborne components. Ground station consists of power electronics, battery module to store the electricity which is then generated, and control unit and drum or a generator module. Airborne components which has a kite control unit, bridle system, sensor unit and kite has an area of a 25 meter square.
As the wind moves, the kite moves in the direction of the wind and wind takes the kite to sky, whereas the tether which is still in connected with the ground station which is only one which connects the ground station and airborne components which is 150 to 400 meters in the length. Principle of kite power generation. This happens in three phases, that is traction phases, retraction phase and power phase. The power phase and retraction phase happens in the sky, up in the air, whereas power phase is connected in the ground. During the retraction phase and traction phase, when the wind moves, the kite actually moves in the direction of a wind and moves from its initial phase. During the retraction phase, the kite again takes the movement in the direction of the wind and makes a circular path due to this wind, and the kite which is connected with the tether to ground station. When the wind flows in the direction that the kite takes the motion regarding to the direction of the wind. This retraction phase gives us in one particular motion. This motion leads to movement of the tether up and down. This tether has connected to ground phase to rotating drum. The rotating drum gains in rotating motion. These are indirectly connected to the power generating unit with the pulleys. Due to this motion of a kite in the sky, the torsion is generated in the rotating drum, and electricity is generated in the rotating engine. Working, this KSU is the unit that allows the automatically piloting a power unit, power kite. That is the kite steering unit, which includes the electric drives, the drums, and all of the hardware needed to control a single kite. The kite generation project has designed and simulated a small-scale prototype. The two kite lines are rolled around the two drums and linked to two electric drives, which are fixed to the ground. Energy is controlled when the wind force on the kite unrolls the line, and the electric drives act as generators due to the rotation of the drums. Here are the comparison between the windmill versus energy kite. Windmill has a range of 1 kilowatt to 3.5 meter of motor, whereas an energy kite it has a range of 1 kilowatt to 10 square meter kite. In windmill, cost around $12,000, whereas in energy kite it is approximately $5,000, which is much lesser than a windmill. Coming to pollution caused by the power generation of during windmill, visualization pollution and noise pollution are the major disadvantages of a windmill. Whereas in kite generation, there is no such problem or disadvantages. I mean, no pollution, effectively silent quietering operation. In windmill, environmental effects are most of the birds were killed, whereas in energy kite less like to kill. Advantages of a kite power generation: it is easy to install, cost effectively, high power to low input, eco-friendly, renewable energy sources. Disadvantages: it requires a continuous monitoring and depends on wind completely. Conclusion: wind power from kites is a potentially renewable energy source, energy technology. High altitude wind power using a tethered wind turbine device has the potential to open up a new wind resource in the area that are not reserved by conventional turbines. Here are some of the references regarding to kite power generation. The design of a combined energy generation using a airborne and ocean current kites in offshore, published by Ho Shang Park, published in the year 2019. Thank you.